I will talk about two ways of building your career. The first one is a bit more proven and perhaps a bit easier. So let's go this way first and see what it offers. And here we are on top of the mountain, looking over the beautiful city of Bergen in Norway. Now, how easy was that? Quite easy, right? And everyone can do it. This might be your path to the top of your programming career using some existing solutions, like for example WordPress or Joomla, or a framework like Laravel or React. I get this question asked a lot, whether you should use some framework or whether you should make everything yourself. And I think that's the wrong question to ask. The right question is, what do you want to be doing in 5 years? You know, when you grow up, do you know the answer to that question, but really, really know the answer? For example, here we were waiting in line with everybody else to take the shortest way up using the cable car that somebody else built for us. So it is some framework that already exists, something that is proven path to the top, if you will, and we got here quickly and easy, no problems. But how much have you learned climbing here? Can you easily climb some other mountain without the cable cart? Where are you going to go from here? Sure, you can install some plugins, play the music on your way up here, and charge some extra money on that. But how much are your clients willing to pay you to take them here a second or the third time to get here? Or could you perhaps lead a team of people to the top of the mountain, to the top of any mountain? And that could be a thing to consider when choosing your way forward. You now know about climbing the mountain as pretty much everybody else here using this same cable cart. So what do you want to be doing when you grow up, you know, in 5 years? Do you prefer the shorter route that somebody else has built for you? Or would you rather learn more about programming itself and take this a bit longer and a more difficult route? Let's see what this path has to offer. If you know the answer to where you want to be in 5 years or when you grow up, whichever comes first, you don't need to ask which framework or programming language to use. You can just see if it will take you where you want to be. Remember, what we use our time on, it's what we become at the end. And there are multiple paths you can take, some short, some long ones. And it all depends on your interests, comfort zone, nerd level, free time, and even environment you are in. For a simple website, using some custom CMS is probably not better than using a WordPress, to be honest. Or for making some business application, using a framework like Laravel is probably better than writing everything on your own. And I hope that you're now wondering, why should you learn the basic vanilla programming then, if it's always better to use existing solutions? Here is what I was thinking 15 years ago when I started. I never looked at my career as something for this week or this month or this year. I was always thinking, what will I do in next 5 years if I continue to work with what is in front of me? Both WordPress and Laravel solve the problems in front of you. But will I be able to work to lead a team of developers, for example, in any framework? Would I be able to choose the company I work with or the clients I work with? Could I switch to .NET or Java or TypeScript if I wanted to? Back then, WordPress was just about starting out and other solutions like Drupal were not that easy to work with. And I've chosen not to work with WordPress because I still believe that WordPress can only get you so far as a programmer. If you look here closely, here we have this graph of knowledge required versus the time needed. And we're WordPress or Drupal or cable cart in our case, we can actually get to this part relatively quickly. We can easily go up, but then we are sort of pretty much at the top. So we cannot get many far from here by using the CMS or cable cart or any other existing solution. The other line is you doing your own thing and you learn on your own, and it will take time. It takes a lot of time to get there. But at the end, you can go much higher with that other line. And here you will have some ups and downs and some showstoppers and everything along the way. But I believe that you can reach much higher levels. You can go much higher because you will know the ins and outs of Laravel and WordPress. You will be the Neo, the one who can make some framework, the one who can make a CMS when needed or some custom system when needed. What do you think who made the WordPress? The guy who learned programming by using WordPress? So in short terms, with WordPress, you can start making money fairly quickly. You just do what everyone else is doing the easy way, and there is a proven path to success. You might have to wait in line, and it can take some time at the end because there are a lot of people waiting in the same line in front of you. But the question is now, what are you going to do when you reach this line with WordPress or Joomla? What have you learned? And I can call it luck or active choice, but I was lucky that I could choose the non-WordPress path. And I started with a bit more harder tasks like integration with Google Maps and eBay and PayPal and whatnot. And before I started working professionally, I actually built my own CMS, but by watching somebody else's code, and I learned a lot of programming concepts by solving some of the problems. And on my first interview, I got the recursion question, which for some reason I understood, even though I've seen a lot of other candidates struggle with it. So, luck, can you learn recursion installing WordPress or some object-oriented principles like solid or dry or design patterns? And Laravel is somewhere in the middle because you can learn a lot using it. But it doesn't solve all the problems in the world, right? Otherwise, no other tool would be available. And I was always determined to learn a bit harder parts of programming, at least object-oriented principles. And WordPress is just not designed to use object-oriented principles, so long-term it would not get me very far. Since Laravel was not existing back then, I did use Zane framework a bit, but majority of things were something that we made ourselves by always learning and improving. And I also got the chance to lead a team of programmers by their choice, actually, both because I was developing my programming skill, but also my communication skill, which are very important. And I still think it was a good choice to make, because I would struggle to change careers in ways that I wanted to. If you get locked up in a single CMS or a single programming language, you cannot just progress very far as a developer. You become what you use your time on. And what do you want to be doing in 5 years? And in my first job as a developer, we chose not to use WordPress, and we were a bit lucky to get a huge client in Los Angeles that also got lucky to fund a lot of their own clients. So each of us developers were making about one custom website a week for 5 years. And by custom, I mean that there were no built plugins for what the clients wanted, so we had to make something new for them. And that built my portfolio very fast, so that I could choose whether I wanted to work, and I chose not to use WordPress. I chose to focus on some more specialized applications, like applications for traffic schools or banks or telecom companies. Having that said, I now use WordPress on my personal blog and some of my websites. So I don't have anything against the WordPress. I love it for what it is, but I never wanted it to be my end goal, my career, if you wish. I also use and love frameworks like Laravel or Yii or FuelPHP or CodeIgniter, but I'm quite familiar with their internal structure and how do they actually do what they're doing. And that is my point. That is why it's a good thing to know how things work on a bit lower level, because then you can pretty much climb any mountains, or you can use pretty much any CMS or any programming language for that matter. Because you can make your own path or even your own cable car to the top of the mountains if you get enough resources and time. And of course it's a harder route, but is it worth it? Only you can decide what's better for you and what's worth it or not. Guess what my question is? Where do you want to be when you grow up? Write me a comment. That is what I think you should have a plan when choosing where you want to work first. Your first company. For example, a company that produces some complex systems or that does some sort of consulting will usually be on the edge of technology, and you will have a chance to work on multiple different projects and learn really a lot. To put it into the perspective, my first 5 years I worked on over 150 projects in a consulting company, and we implemented our own solution for others, so I really learned a lot. In comparison to the last 5 years where I was working as an internal developer, I really learned a lot as well, but I worked on maybe 10 projects. For me, that's not that important, as I still have a nice portfolio, but I'm sure my life would be quite different had I not started with a consultant company first. So I chose not to use WordPress, not because I didn't want the money, but because I always ask what I want to learn, where will it get me, how will my portfolio look like, what is in there for me long term. Again, I was sort of lucky that I could work in a car wash service while I was learning programming. Somebody might not have that option at all, so do what you have to do. And you will be right thinking that WordPress and Drupal are very popular and that everybody uses them. And that is sort of true. However, the real reason they are popular is, if you come closer here. If I were to make this pyramid here, there are multiple levels of it. And this horizontal will be the popularity. And this vertical will be the expertise. Or again, the salary that you could be paid eventually. And here we have the most popular CMSs like WordPress, like Joomla, Drupal and others. And they are very popular for a reason. That is because startups and other small clients want the most for their website and the most for their buck. Which makes perfect sense because WordPress and others are perfect for what they are intended to do. And the widest demand is sort of an quote-unquote easy doable job. You objectively don't need a lot of expertise to install WordPress, you just follow some tutorial. And that is why there is a huge demand here. But there is also a huge waiting line in front of the cable cart, as we've seen. Laravel is somewhere here in the middle, with a bit lesser demand, and that's why you don't hear about it often,
But the more skills are required, so does your salary might be higher about. And here at the top are some more specialized apps. Or perhaps Magento might be here. Or some custom-built apps that do not exist on the market yet. And sure, you can and maybe should combine the long-term plans to get you where you need by doing also some short-term plans to get some money for this month. But just be careful, because again, what you use your time on is what you will become in the end. Now, are you going to make a better CMS than the WordPress? One that's easier to use, with more plugins, better community? I wish you all the luck in the world if you try, but chances are slim. Also, are you going to be the top-notch programmer by only making WordPress themes integration and building plugins? Master all the object-oriented principles or whatever your programming style is? So again, by having a long-term plan, you can choose what to work with and for how long. And always see if the project you put on your portfolio is actually pushing you towards the goal that you want to achieve. Then you can decide whether you should use the WordPress or the cable card, or go the hard path. What do you want to establish yourself as? A programmer who can do things quickly by using pre-built solutions? Or the programmer who can solve very difficult problems by using the rough route? Because basically both paths lead to the top of the mountain. The question is, what motivates you the most? Do you need to quickly see results of your work? Or do you like seeing yourself improving? But it's not about the framework, it's about you. Where do you want to be in 5 years? You know, when you grow up.